Need a dark horse team in the Mountain West? Fresno State's your team. A team that, you know, had its ups and downs, and the Carr brothers were there. They obviously had some excitement, but they haven't been the same since. This could be the year that they return to compete for a Mountain West title, maybe. There's a lot of talent on this roster. There's guys at the top, especially on the offense, a three-headed monster that we'll talk about today that teams gonna have to prepare for, and that's a big reason why they could be competing for a conference championship. At number 10, we have cornerback Braylon Lux, 30 tackles and one pick last year. The defense is going to be one that is a group that you're going to have to watch. The offense should be just fine, but there's still talent on this defense. The defensive line and the secondary will be strengths of this defense, the cornerback specifically and defensive line, that is. But the secondary and the defensive line will be the strengths of the defense, and the defense will have to step up if the offense is what people think it's going to be. Speaking of offense, number 9, wide receiver Carrick Wheatfall. Honorable mention, Mountain West last year, 363 yards, average 15.8 yards per catch. Just one of the many options that this offense has. Number 8, safety Evan Williams. Like I said, the secondary is going to be a strength. Honorable mention, Mountain West last year, 227 tackles, two passes defended. It's going to be tough to pass the ball against the Bulldogs, and that's going to be huge, especially with the offense giving them plenty of practice to be that team, that unit that they need to be. Number 7, defensive end Kwame Jones. Honorable mention up Mountain West last year. Six tackles for loss, five sacks. This defensive line is very talented. There's another defensive end that we'll talk about, another defensive lineman that we'll also talk about here in a little bit. Like I said, the front and the back of the defense will be just fine. It just comes down to the linebacker play. Number 6, Wylan Free. Four passes defended, one pick. If there's one thing that wide receivers don't do against him is they do not run free. And he is going to be an all-conference potential player. Like I said, this secondary is very talented and has the ability to make sure that teams struggle passing the ball against them. Number 5, defensive tackle Kevin Atkins. Honorable mention, Mountain West last year. 4.5 tackles for loss. All of them were sacks. Guy who's going to be disruptive up the middle while teams are worried about the edge. Number 4, Jake Haener at quarterback. Could take another step. The former Washington transfer threw over 2,000 yards with 14 touchdowns and 5 picks. I think people are expecting him to take a step forward in his development, and that could mean big things for the Fresno State offense. Number 3, wide receiver Jaylen Cropper could be the go-to wide receiver for Haener. Honorable mention all Mountain West last year, 520 yards and 5 touchdowns. Some people are thinking that he's taking a step back, but I think that this is a reliable threat that can be what Haener needs him to be. And this offense has a lot of potential in the passing game as well. Number 2, defensive end David Perales, second team all Mountain West with 8.5 tackles for loss, 4.5 sacks. He and Jones are going to be tough to block on the edge. And honestly, that opens up the field for Atkins if needed. But Jones could also see the field open up if teams are trying to block Perales a little bit more. They're going to be disrupted this year, and that's huge for getting the ball back to this offense. And number 1, Ronnie Rivers, guy who's been super reliable both in the running game and the passing game. Very good hands out of the backfield. First team all Mountain West with 501 yards and 7 touchdowns rushing, and he also had 265 yards and 2 touchdowns receiving. Could have a breakout year. Who knows? All I know is Fresno State has the talent to compete for a conference championship. It's just a matter of some depth at some positions, and can linebacker play be good? Can the offensive line give Haener the time he needs and the running room that Rivers needs to break free? His top 10 is very, very talented, like I said. And it'll be interesting to see what this team can do. I really like a lot of these pieces, and that means good things for this team in 2021.